हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बालाजी राव। वेलकम टू बीआर मैथ्स क्लास। इन अर्लियर क्लासेस वी लर्न अबाउट डॉट प्रोडक्ट एंड वी प्रैक्टिस प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन डॉट प्रोडक्ट। इन केस इफ यू नॉट वॉच्ड दोज वीडियोस, आई विल गिव दैट प्लेलिस्ट लिंक इन कार्ड्स। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट, एंड वी विल लर्न वॉट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ए बार क्रॉस बी बार, and what is the magnitude of a bar cross b bar, and most importantly we will learn what is meant by right hand system of vectors, and we will learn why a bar cross b bar equal to minus of b bar cross a bar. All these things we are going to learn in this class. Before going to start this video, please drop a like for this video. Without much delay, let's begin the class. First, we will learn the definition of cross product. The definition is like this. Let a bar comma b bar are any two non-zero vectors. Why non-zero vectors? Angle between zero vectors is not defined. That's why we should consider a bar b bar are two non-zero vectors. And theta is angle between the vectors a bar comma b bar. I considered two non-zero vectors a bar b bar and theta is angle between them. Further, the definition is like this. Cross product of vectors a bar comma b bar is denoted by a bar cross b bar. And the cross product of vectors is defined like this. Defined as magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar into sine theta into n cap. Here, what is n cap? This is important. What is n cap? Please listen this carefully. What is n cap? N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both the vectors a bar and b bar, such that a bar b bar n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. This is very very important. A bar b bar n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. Don't worry, I'll explain what is n cap, what is right hand system of vectors. Before that, I'll conclude this definition. Cross product of vectors a bar comma b bar is denoted by a bar cross b bar, and a bar cross b bar is defined as magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar into sine theta into n cap. Here, what is n cap? N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both a bar comma b bar, such that a bar b bar n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. To understand this definition, I'll use this to explain this definition. I hope you can see. This is a bar. This black color one is a bar. This white color side is b bar. You suppose like that. A bar, b bar. What is this? You can see here. This is n cap. What they are saying about n cap? N cap is a unit vector. Okay, you suppose this is one unit length. N cap is a unit vector. What they are saying? N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both a bar and b bar. You observe this. This is n cap, na? This is perpendicular to a bar. You can see this. You can see this is perpendicular to a bar. At the same time, this is perpendicular to b bar. This is the unit vector which is perpendicular to a bar, which is perpendicular to b bar. This is important, such that a bar, b bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. What it mean? A bar, b bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. What it mean? It means that this is a bar na, this is b bar na. Place a screw here. I placed a screw here. You can see this. Okay. Please observe. This is a bar. This is b bar. I placed a screw at this point. If I rotate this screw in the sense of a bar to b bar, as I rotate this screw in the sense of a bar to b bar, please observe. What happening? You observe the screw. What happening? What happening? Observe. What happening? Screw is moving upward direction. So this is a bar. This is b bar. I placed a screw here. When I rotate in the sense of a bar to b bar, the screw is moving upward direction. The screw is moving upward direction. So we say that a bar b bar n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. In this definition, only the thing you need to understand about this n cap. This is a bar, this is b bar. When I rotate the screw in the sense of a bar to b bar, the screw is moving upward direction. If the screw is moving upward direction, then we say that a bar, b bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. I hope you understand this definition. Once again, I'll quickly recall what is the definition of cross product of vectors. A bar comma b bar are any two non-zero vectors and theta is angle between them. Then cross product of vectors a bar comma b bar is denoted by a bar cross b bar. and it is defined as magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sin theta into n cap. What is n cap? N cap is the unit vector which is perpendicular to both A bar comma B bar, such that A bar, B bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. See here, if you observe the diagram, this is A bar, this is B bar, and theta is angle between them. This is n cap. N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, such that A bar, B bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. What is the direction of A bar cross B bar? You observe this magnitude of A bar, this is a scalar. You observe this magnitude of B bar, this is also scalar. Here what is theta? Theta is angle between the vectors A bar comma B bar, and this theta value always lies in between 0 and 180. 0 is possible, 180 also possible. Theta is in first quadrant or second quadrant? If theta is in first quadrant or second quadrant, we know that in first quadrant sin theta is positive, in second quadrant also sin theta is positive. So this is positive. You observe this, this is magnitude of A bar. Magnitude of A bar is a scalar and it is positive. Magnitude of B bar is a scalar and it is positive. For some angle theta, sin theta is a scalar and sin theta is also positive, because theta may be in first quadrant or in second quadrant. Multiplication of three scalars is again a scalar. As these three are positive, after multiplying, I'll get positive number. You learn about this M A bar. For a positive scalar M, what is the direction of M A bar? The direction of M A bar is same when M is positive. If M is positive, M A bar is along the direction of A bar. You observe, this whole thing is a scalar. This is like M, and moreover, this is positive. What is the direction of M into N cap? As M is positive, the direction of M into N cap is along the direction of N cap. What is N cap? N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both A bar comma B bar, such that A bar, B bar, N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. See, right hand system of vectors, when I placed a screw, it is moving upward direction. This is the direction of N cap. Please try to understand. This is the direction of N cap. So as M is positive, M into N cap is also along this direction only. This vector direction is along the direction of N cap. What is the direction of A bar cross B bar? Observe. This is the direction of A bar cross B bar. A bar cross B bar is along the direction of N cap. I hope you are understanding. N cap is perpendicular to both A bar comma B bar. So A bar cross B bar also. A bar cross B bar is a vector which is perpendicular to both A bar as well as B bar. I hope you understand. What is the direction of A bar cross B bar? The direction of A bar cross B bar is along the direction of N cap. What is the direction of N cap? As A bar, B bar, N cap forms a right hand system of vectors, this is the direction of N cap. So A bar cross B bar also along the same direction. So you learn the definition of cross product of vectors, and you learn what is the direction of A bar cross B bar. In this cross product of vectors, around 14 formulas are there, I think. I'm going to discuss all those formulas. If possible, I'll derive all the results. Around 14 formulas are there. If you are thorough in all those 14 formulas, then cross product problems you can do very easily. First formula. How you got this formula? This formula you got from the definition of cross product of vectors. What is the first formula? A bar cross B bar equal to magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sin theta into N cap. This is first formula in cross product of vectors. Now I'll calculate what is magnitude of A bar cross B bar. This is very, very important. Listen carefully. A bar cross B bar is this one I written here. Okay. Now I need to calculate magnitude of this vector. You observe, this is a scalar. Moreover, these three things are positive. You know this formula. Magnitude of M A bar is what? That is modulus of M into modulus of A bar. As M is positive, modulus of M is M only. So modulus of M A bar is M into modulus of A bar. So here, what is magnitude of this? See, this whole thing is M. M, scalar I am writing outside first. Magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sin theta. This is the scalar, na? This scalar I written outside. Into magnitude of N cap. I hope you are understanding. As you know this formula, magnitude of M A bar is M times of magnitude of A bar. This can be written like this. Magnitude of N cap. What do you know about N cap? Cap is there, na? It is a unit vector. In the definition also we specified. N cap is a unit vector. Unit vector means its magnitude is 1 unit. So magnitude of N cap is 1. So magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta into 1 is what? Which is same as magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta. This is the second formula. Magnitude of A bar plus B bar is magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta. So till now you learned two formulas. A bar plus B bar is magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta into n cap. Magnitude of A bar cross B bar is magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta. You observe here n cap is not there. Magnitude of A bar cross B bar is what? Magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta. From this we will get sine theta formula. What is sine theta from this? From this what is sine theta? Sine theta equal to, you take magnitude of A bar, magnitude of B bar to the left hand side. What is sine theta? Sine theta is magnitude of A bar cross B bar divided by magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar. If you observe all these three formulas comes from the definition of cross product of vectors only. Very, very important result. I am going to derive this result. What is this result? A bar cross B bar is minus of B bar cross A bar. You observe in dot product, A bar dot B bar is same as B bar dot A bar. But in cross product, A bar cross B bar is not B bar cross A bar. You observe here. A bar cross B bar is minus of B bar cross A bar. I am going to derive this result. Just now, you learned the definition of cross product of vectors. What is A bar cross B bar? From the definition of cross product of vectors, you know that A bar cross B bar is magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta into n cap. Here, what is n cap? N cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both A bar comma B bar such that A bar, B bar, N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. This is we learned from the definition of cross product of vectors. To prove this result, first I'll write B bar cross A bar. B bar cross A bar. As per the definition, how I can write B bar cross A bar? Magnitude of B bar into magnitude of A bar into sine theta. What is theta here? Angle between the vectors B bar comma A bar into, you need to write a unit vector here such that B bar, A bar, this vector forms a right hand system of vectors. As we discussed in the definition, A bar, B bar, N cap. This is the direction of A bar cross B bar. That's why we are saying that A bar, B bar, N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. Now you observe, this is B bar, this is A bar, this is N cap. B bar, A bar, N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. Forms a right hand system of vectors. When I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar, if I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar, if screw moves in this direction, if screw moves along the direction of n cap, then we can say that B bar, A bar, n cap forms a right hand system of vectors. You observe, I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar. You observe what happens. Screw is moving upward direction? No, screw is not moving along the direction of n cap. Please try to understand, the screw is coming downward direction. When I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar, screw is coming downward direction. Screw is moving this direction. See, this is n cap. This is minus n cap. So what do you understand here? B bar, A bar, N cap not forming a right hand system of vectors. B bar, A bar minus N cap. B bar, A bar minus N cap. When I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar, the screw is moving along the direction of minus N cap. Understanding or not? See, when I rotate the screw in the sense of B bar to A bar, the screw is moving downward direction along the direction of minus N cap. So here, B bar, A bar, minus N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. So here, I need to write a unit vector such that B bar, A bar, that unit vector forms a right hand system of vectors. Here, B bar, A bar, minus N cap. B bar, A bar, minus N cap forms a right hand system of vectors. This is B bar cross A bar. This minus is there, na? This minus I'll write here. Okay. As these two are scalars, you know that 2 into 3 is same as 3 into 2. So magnitude of B bar into magnitude of A bar can be written as magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar. Okay. And what is theta here? Theta is angle between B bar comma A bar. We know that angle between B bar comma A bar is same as angle between A bar comma B bar. So this is sine theta. This is as usual because angle between A bar comma B bar is same as angle between B bar comma A bar. Into, as I written this minus here, this is into n cap. So that equal to this minus I'll write here. Now you observe this magnitude of A bar into magnitude of B bar into sine theta into n cap. What is this? This is nothing but A bar cross B bar.
I hope you are understanding. What I got? I got that B bar cross A bar equal to minus of A bar cross B bar. Multiply with minus on both sides. Multiply with minus on both sides. What you will get? This side what you will get? Minus of B bar cross A bar equal to A bar cross B bar. So what is A bar cross B bar? A bar cross B bar is minus of B bar cross A bar.
So finally, what I proved? I proved that A bar cross B bar is minus of B bar cross A bar. I hope you understand this. Fifth point. What is direction of A bar cross B bar? A bar cross B bar direction is along the direction of n cap. You observe this. This is A bar cross B bar, na? This is perpendicular to A bar. You can see this is perpendicular to B bar also. So I'll write the same point. So from now onwards, if someone asks, find a vector which is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar, then we will calculate A bar cross B bar only. Listen carefully. I'm going to discuss one more important thing. See, this is A bar, this is B bar. You observe this flat surface. You observe here, flat surface is there. You observe this flat surface. This is what? This is the plane generated by A bar comma B bar. A bar cross B bar is perpendicular to A bar as well as B bar. That we know. Not only that, A bar cross B bar is a vector which is perpendicular to the plane generated by A bar comma B bar. This is the plane generated by A bar comma B bar. A bar cross B bar is a vector which is perpendicular to plane. This plane. Plane means flat surface. A bar cross B bar is perpendicular to the plane generated by A bar comma B bar. I hope you understand this. One more important point. This is A bar cross B bar, na? This is perpendicular to A bar. This is perpendicular to B bar. You observe this one. This is A bar cross B bar, na? This is A bar cross B bar. This is minus of A bar cross B bar. This is A bar cross B bar. This is opposite direction. This is the direction of A bar cross B bar. This is opposite direction of A bar cross B bar. That means this is minus of A bar cross B bar. If you observe carefully, minus of A bar cross B bar is perpendicular to A bar. This is perpendicular to B bar. What I am trying to say? I am trying to say that A bar cross B bar is a vector which is perpendicular to both A bar as well as B bar at the same time. At the same time, minus of A bar cross B bar, this is also perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. So what I can write here, plus or minus A bar cross B bar. A bar cross B bar, perpendicular to both A bar comma B bar. Minus of A bar cross B bar, that is also perpendicular to both the vectors A bar and B bar. Sixth point, last point in this class. In the definition, I taken A bar comma B bar are any two non-zero vectors. Listen this last point. A bar or B bar or both are zero vectors. That means any one vector is zero vector or both are zero vectors, then A bar cross B bar is defined. In the test book itself, they are saying that if either A bar or B bar or both are zero vectors, then A bar cross B bar is defined as zero bar. You cannot question. If one vector is zero vector, then angle between them is not defined. How you will say A bar cross B bar as zero bar? Like that, you cannot question. This is the definition. They are defined like that. If any one of the vector are zero vector or both are zero vectors, then cross product of these two vectors is defined as zero vector. Suppose if you want to calculate A bar cross zero bar, here one vector is zero vector, now what is the cross product of these two vectors? It is defined as zero bar. Or else you want to calculate like this, zero bar cross B bar. Here one vector is zero vector, now this is written as zero bar. I hope you understand this point. What we learned in this class, we learned the definition of cross product of vectors and we learned six important points related to cross product of vectors. If you like this video, please drop a like for this video and share this video with your friends. In case if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, subscribe now. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.